Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's Road Extra. This week, I'm very excited. We're welcoming back a friend of the Road Show, one of our favorites, Barbi Jo from 92 Pro FM. Hi, Barbi. How are you?
I'm terrific, Emily. Just fantastic. I missed your beautiful face.
Oh, I miss you, too. All I can do is hear you now on the radio. I can't even see you, which is so difficult.
It's so hard. I look forward to the day that we will reunite.
I know, me too. But in the meantime, I figured now would be the perfect time to speak to you because a lot of people are listening to music right now, especially being stuck at home. So let's talk about summer music. I guess we'll start off by talking about the contenders for the song of the summer.
Oh, well, you know what? We're halfway through the summer. I can't say there's one definitive clear winner just yet. Like, look at the summer's past. Songs like Despacito that blew up, and everybody knows it. It's an earworm. It's your summer anthem. Mm-hmm. You know the lyrics, whether you despise the song or not. But there are a few contenders that are in the running.
Right.
I will say one big one you and I kind of chatted about earlier. It's almost like he wrote a song about summer, Harry Styles.
We all love him.
Watermelon Sugar. I mean, if that doesn't make you want a watermelon Dells, I don't know what will.
You're right.
I think that's what he wrote it about for Rhode Islanders. And yeah. So we thank you, Harry. It's a great summery vibe song, you know? Mm-hmm. Plain and simple. It's getting a lot of play. You hear it continuously on 92 Pro FM. Mm-hmm. Other songs that I think are in the running, What Star Power behind Lady Gaga and Ariana Grande's Rain On Me. Great pop song that we needed in this moment.
So
and
catchy.
It's groovy. It's like got a clubby vibe to it. So I think that we shouldn't rule out Gaga and Grande. Two fierce ladies, so I love it. It's like, girls, report to the dance floor when we can go back to the dance floor.
You're right.
And I think two of the other big ones are Megan Thee Stallion featuring Beyonce, Savage. If you don't know the lyrics to Savage, shame on you. You are ratchet.
It's all over the place.
I mean, and of course, the big one, because it's not just about this moment, it's about a movement, I would say, is DaBaby and Roddy Ricch, Rockstar.
Yes.
Huge right now, having historical significance and racial justice, you know, a message behind it, which is big. It'll bring you back to the summer of 2020, our pandemic summer. It's like, and the movement of what's happening too.
Yeah, that's a good point. So all of those songs we kind of spoke about earlier, everyone's talking about them, but then when is this the song ultimately picked?
You know, I would say it's around Labor Day weekend where you kind of rewind on summer and say, hey, what was that one song that was your summer anthem, your soundtrack to summer, the standout, the one that got, like I said, it was continuously played, continuously heard. People were streaming it. It went viral. You hear it all over TikTok. So there's got to be that one clear, definitive song. And we will declare that song probably around Labor Day.
Okay. All right. So we'll wait for that. We'll wait for the big results and the big finale. I'm excited. In the meantime, we'll just keep listening to these great songs.
Right.
And then something else I wanted to touch upon is, obviously, we're in a pandemic and artists are stuck at home. What are they doing to kind of, they're not able to go out to the studio? What's kind of the alternative plans?
Well, many of them are making music at home, and you know they're lucky enough if they have a studio in their home. Or I saw people like Ryan Tedder from One Republic had this whole setup in almost like a tour bus outside that was a built studio for himself. So they're having their moment of making music in an odd and different way now. I talked to one group and they were making music at home in their closet because they said the acoustics were amazing.
I've heard that.
It's funny to hear everybody, how they're reacting to this very strange moment. And the music industry has been impacted in a way where they had a lot of tough decisions to make. I mean, artists who were supposed to release music either delayed their albums, postponed their albums, or some of them surprised us with music early because they felt we needed the music to heal us right now, to unite us right now, to be a distraction right now. The music is what keeps us going.
Yes.
It keeps me going. It keeps me motivated.
Yes. Oh, same here. Well, thank you so much for joining us today.
Emily, thank you always. Stay safe. We mask up and we're going to summer safely. And when we have that song of the summer, we'll let you know.
That's great. Thank you so much, Barbi Jo.
Thank you, Em.
For this week's Road Extra, I'm Emily Gibbs.